This is Melody Cush.
This is Lana Del Rey.
Hey, Sex Squad.
Check out Sex Tales right now.
Sex Tales.
I don't even have any pants on.
Yes. But, like, your success is really just, I mean, it's surprising that you haven't won an award before this year, but I'm glad that you're being, like, recognized for all your amazingness. Do you have any tips and tricks for people who want to start camming? Maybe just, like, some things to keep in mind to help create success and longevity?
Oof. I probably could write, like, an encyclopedia on that topic. Mm-hmm. So to try and pare it down, do as much research as possible. Because even before I started camming, I like secretly researched it for like literally 2 years. And I still was not fully prepared when I started. Mm-hmm. Like, as I got into camming and a few years later, I look back and I'm like, I should have done this. I should have done that and like been better prepared. So do as much research as possible. And the best way to research, which I didn't do enough, was to catch a model right when they log on and watch their entire show. Like for your favorite top models, like I would set my alarm and catch them the second they logged on and then watch the entire show. Because when you just watch snippets, you're not going to have like a proper understanding of it. And then other than that is really research the safety, like things you need to do to keep yourself safe, and also the consequences of being naked on the internet forever. Because mm-hmm. you, as much as you might think you might be the exception to that rule, you're not. And your nudes will be found by everyone you know. Your parents will see your nudes. Like, I don't think there's a way around it.
Yeah, and I think it's really important what you said about watching other broadcasters, because not only do you see, maybe you get inspired about the type of model you want to be, but you also kind of get a feel for the type of model you might not want to be, in a sense. Like, you just, it helps you find your own place in the industry, and you can kind of like focus on those things that bring you joy and, you know, be your authentic self and bring you joy, kind of thing.
Oh, yeah.
That's interesting. I never watch other models. I never wanted to watch other models because I didn't want to ever like accidentally claim anything that they were. So I was like, no, I'm just going to, I don't know, bump into walls until I find a door.
Honestly, though, I think there's a benefit to that, Lana, because a lot of models that I talk to, they'll be like, I have to act like so-and-so to be successful. And I'm like, no. You literally can create your entire own brand and style of camming. Do what you're comfortable with, and you don't have to force yourself into these like molds that you see other people doing. So by not watching people, you're able to just be yourself and be successful.
It's kind of like that misconception of when you first start camming, you think that you have to be this highly sexualized creature and just like always on the brink of an orgasm, but really you can just like be a goober and it's fine.
Like either one's gonna make money. Just do what you enjoy. Do my two-step.
Hey, Sex Squad, remember to spank that like button and subscribe on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/cammingLife.
And make sure to subscribe to Sex Tales wherever you listen to your favorite podcast.
Yes!